today I've got Jeff Horton here. Jeff is here. He's going to be talking to us about Van Halen stuff. He is in the band Fair Warning, which is the Van Halen tribute band. If you ever see a Van Halen tribute band, you have to see these guys. And Jeff is essentially Eddie in the band. He's going to be here showing off his guitar playing, talking to us about guitars, about experience, about the industry, just playing and everything you could ever really want to know, including some of Eddie's little tricks. So, without further ado, we're going to kick off with Craigslist. Okay, this was actually a really good ad. It was straight to the point, brief, had a web link, but you guys have to check out the name, finkenbinderaudio.com. I only pronounced it right because I said it 20 times just before starting this show. Let me tell you, all you need is a catchy name. Maybe an abbreviation couldn't hurt too. Alright, kudos to Finkenbinder Audio. Yeah, your guess is as good as mine. I don't know what in the world this is other than a band trying to advertise their MySpace page. I think it's interesting that they went as far as to try to make a fancy photo that they uploaded with their logo and their MySpace name, but yet it was too much of an effort to just simply type the MySpace name at the top where we were expecting it to be. Location unknown. Definitely not Earth. Okay, so this is just another example of why I think Craigslist needs an enema if they don't get their friggin' security up. This is absurd that nobody monitors these things. This person posted for a guitar player for his band. He cursed, which is why there's big red apple over effing. Violent, crazy, drug habit, what are we promoting here? This is baloney. Go find yourself somebody somewhere else, and don't put this stuff up where kids can see it. This is disgusting, this is absurd, get a life. A little reply to an ad, the original ad titled, "Where are all the singers and comedians at?" The answer, they are behind the preposition. Indeed. Okay, acoustic guitarist seeks violin improviser to write music with. Personally, I would consider this if I was a violinist. I love the idea of it, it sounds like a great project. What I've circled is the word improviser and the word write in the body, and write also occurs in the title. These are two different ideas. Improviser might also not be quite the best word, but writing is very structured, improvisation is more impromptu, one has nothing to do with the other, they work very well together, but they are completely two different ideas, and a better way to phrase this might be looking for someone to collaborate with and write music, improvisational skills a plus. Very often, I'm not saying you see it here, but you do see improvisation as sort of a type of musical style. It's a talent. Let's just put it that way. This ad has been up and down a few times for the last couple of weeks that I've noticed, and I haven't commented on it until now. There's only one overall sort of thing about the ad that's too much, and that's it's too much information. If you look at it, it looks like a gigantic autobiography about the band, something you'd say for a MySpace page or a website or something else of the sort, but it doesn't have any place on the Craigslist ad, because when you read it, it sounds just like I just spoke. It's just way too much information, and it's excessive. Let's get down to business here. We've circled two updates in here. It reminds me of a software page. Update version 1, version 1.0, version 1.2. We don't want to know the updates. Give us the current status. Again, the 5 W's will get you straight to the point. There are also two little tidbits in here that I circled that are just not necessary. One is that you sign the lease of a house. You sign the lease for a house, not of a house. That is very admirable. Perhaps it has something to do with what you're looking to do, but we're very thankful that you're not homeless. Everyone should have somewhere to live. Tell us about it later. And the other bit, recording our music on a laptop with the GarageBand software that comes preloaded on MacBooks. GarageBand and Mac is awesome. I'm a supporter, I'm a user, I love it. Incidentally, GarageBand comes with every Mac on the market, not just the MacBooks. Why not just say, we've been recording and we want to record more? And now, let's meet the band. Here they are. Can you guys say Facebook? These pictures look like they belong on your Facebook. They don't really have anything to do with music. You look like a fun bunch of guys. I'd hang out with you. But hanging out in the hallway or sitting on the floor talking or at the beach, doesn't really say anything about band. How about some pictures of you guys hanging out together in a group photo sort of pose, or perhaps even with instruments? All right. Do you recognize this one? Produced a number one hit for Vanessa Williams, toured with Cyndi Lauper and others. Yes, last time he was looking for your band so that he could be in it and be a strong part of it, as well as other things. This one is now stating that he's looking to score an indie film and a video and a documentary. Obviously looking for another avenue. Nothing wrong with that. Kudos, man. Go for it, I say. I do it myself. In fact, currently I'm writing for a video game that will be out for Xbox 360. And that's really exciting work because it's something different, so right on. I just have some confusion with the ad. It says, let us score, and then it says, I've written, and then it says, we will do any of those things. Well, are you an us, an I've, or a we? Plural, singular, whatever it is, just please let us know. Okay, the battles continue. Sorry, a wigger with a laptop is not music. I didn't find the original ad, I'm not sure who started this, but obviously somebody posted something having to do with hip-hop or techno or something, and sure enough, somebody's replied and the battle began, and this one says, you are really dumb, huh, to imply someone using a laptop to make music is a white dude making hip-hop, blah blah blah. Just write them personally, we don't all want to hear your stuff. Oh boy, alright, the long, long ads are back. Let's just write longer ones to retaliate against the other ones, because if I'm more wordy, my point is better than your point. Look, you guys are sitting there attacking each other behind your computers. It's cowardly, it's childish, it's silly. Don't do it. Just spare us having to read these things or even skip past them. If you really want to have a debate, start a public debate somewhere, have a debate team, or just write each other directly and actually have an actual argument. You're driving us nuts as the readers. But putting all that aside, why don't we break this ad down, shall we? Techno is not real music. Okay, supporting the idea, against the idea, whatever your point is, these are the statements that are unnecessary. Take it from a musician. Techno is not real music by traditional standards. It's not. It has nothing to do with anything. It's the creation of everything that's fundamental in music, but it's artificial. And real implies non-artificial. So it's not organic in that sense, but it exists as an art form, and it does require a skill, and people should have respect for the people that have that skill. If you don't have it and somebody else does, they've worked for it, they've earned it, and that's cool. However, let's not make these statements. The other comment in here, which if you read it a couple of times, I had to rub my eyes. I'd rather hear a great, yes, it's in there twice, somebody was not proofreading because they were ranting so quickly. I'd rather hear a great DJ than a bad acoustic singer, songwriter, or jazz. Well, yeah, and I'd rather not hear bad techno. Anything bad sucks. That was a terrible point, and don't insult jazz. Jazz is like one of the highest forms of music. It's extremely difficult, and if you accomplish jazz, you can accomplish anything if you can accomplish jazz things. And jazz is tough. So yeah, let's just poke at things we don't like, because that makes sense. The ever so mature. And then, as we will all know, when backing up your facts, always have a strong quote behind them, because it shows intellect. Here's a quote by Winston Churchill. If it wasn't for all the shite, that good stuff wouldn't sound so good. Yes, I said shite. If it wasn't for all the shite, the good stuff wouldn't sound so good. Look up this wonderful quote on Google. I looked it up various different ways, and it doesn't exist. Winston Churchill probably never said this, and I can't imagine why in his era of history, anybody...